Energy and Civilization, a History by Vaclav Smil. Energy is the universal currency. One of its many forms must be transformed to get anything done. Hi and welcome to the BookLab. I'm Björn and today we're going to talk about energy and civilization. Every major shift in human civilization, from the rise of agriculture to the Industrial Revolution, has been driven by the way we harness and use energy. In Energy and Civilization, Vaclav Smil meticulously traces this relationship, showing how our ability to extract energy from the world has shaped everything from how we live to how we work and how societies organize themselves. Quote, "From a fundamental biophysical perspective, both prehistoric human evolution and the course of history can be seen as the quest for controlling greater stores and flows of more concentrated, more versatile forms of energy, and converting them in more affordable ways, at lower costs and with higher efficiencies, into heat, light, and motion. Agriculture became possible because we learned how to capture and redirect solar energy into crops. Cities and empires rose because we figured out how to store and distribute food, which is just another type of energy. The Industrial Revolution exploded when we tapped into fossil fuels, allowing us to expand what we could build, move, and create radically." Bringing my thoughts to Ostwald's energetic imperative that is mentioned in this book, quote, "Do not waste any energy, make it useful." Inspired by the laws of thermodynamics, Ostwald argued that societies should strive to minimize energy waste in both life and in industry and in everyday human action. One of the book's strengths is how Smil refuses to oversimplify history. He doesn't fall into the trap of technological determinism. Energy doesn't cause political or social change, but it enables it. And each energy transition also brought with it its own unintended consequences. The move from wood to coal didn't just bring us industrialization, it also fueled imperial expansion, wealth inequality, and environmental destruction. Smil's book is rigorous, it's packed with data, historical context and comparisons. He is also skeptical of grand predictions, whether they come from techno-optimists that promise limitless clean energy in the future, or doomers who see collapse as inevitable. Instead, he sticks to the facts. Quote, "The availability of power sources determines the amount of work activity that can exist. And the control of these power flows determines the power in man's affairs and his relative influence on nature." End quote. My favorite part of this book was the story of how we got to where we are today. How human muscle was replaced by animal power and then eventually replaced by machinery. It was also super interesting to read about how adoption of new energy sources have played out throughout history. Adoption is usually pretty slow, and it's not until a new technology hits a critical mass that mass adoption actually happens. It can take years, a generation, before an old technique is replaced by a new way of harnessing power, and I find this very interesting as we move into this new age of humanoid robots and everything that is just close by in the future. The robotic revolution is going to be a spectacle to live through, and it's exciting times that we live in. This book is not the easiest read in the world. I read it as an audiobook, which helped, and then I had the physical copy as support. It has a lot of nice graphs, and it's just very detailed, but it doesn't get boring. It provided me with a new lens through which to see the world, through the lens of how we use energy. I find this an important book and probably the most powerful book that I've read this year so far. So if you're ready to take on a more demanding book, Energy and Civilization, A History by Vaclav Smil is a book that should go on your reading list. Now I want to know what you are reading this week. Please post that in the comment. If you read this book, what was your experience? Let me know about that, because I love chatting with you guys. I'm back next week with more book reviews. Probably it's Hayek's book, The Road to Serfdom, that I will review. So socialism will get a punch in the face next week, because Hayek is no fan of planned societies. So that's going to be exciting. Until then, Björn out. Have a great week. Happy reading. Bye-bye.